then the best time for me to do this, rather than just taking a time out of my day to do this, he's just gonna report me, show it to you guys on me, and then we'll just collect that. Right?
Unless you decide that.
We still do the kettlebell.
No, the way we, the way you pick it up.
Right, both ways. I'm showing you another way. I don't mind the other way. What happened is that they do exactly what you said. Oh, they pick it up, and unlike me, I haven't seen you do the kettlebell before. They come up, and they literally stand up straight, and they start hip punching the kettlebell straight.
Oh, right? After they
pick it up. So the idea here is that you create momentum of the kettlebell swing, and then you go up, right? Where they stand up like this and they start doing this, like hyperextension of that lumbar spine. Again, as you guys are training, make sure that thing gets put back exactly where it needs to be. Including the sandbags, including everything, especially the cubbies for both locations. Make sure that we put it back. Let's go through the exercises.
Yeah, it is. Okay.
We were talking about last week, how the demonstration and whatnot. So make sure that we are looking at people's form. We talked about last week, there's no point of going through these exercises when we can't and don't do them. Don't apply them to the workouts, right? Make sure that people are doing the exercise correctly. Okay. I came back from a conference and Rachel Cosgrove, Alan Cosgrove's wife, was there as a keynote speaker, and she reminded me about something. She said, what they do at their gym is that if somebody's doing it incorrectly, they will show them how to do it again, they will give them the verbal cue how to do it. If they still can't do it after you work with them, right, you have to regress the exercise. Does that make sense? You have to regress an exercise. So if I'm looking again on camera, then I'm looking at an exercise and you're like, well, that person, he can't do it. And at that point, I will ask, why did you regress the exercise? Right? They were not ready for the exercise. If they can't do it correctly and you're still working with them and you're still giving the cue, you gave the cue, you show how to do it, you point it out to other people, and they still can't do it, you cannot let them continue doing that exercise, because they won't do it correctly and they won't hurt themselves. Does that make sense? Okay. So all of the stuff that I gave out, I used to do this, but I'm just going to stick with more of this and continue to do this in the future, is that all the exercise modification, if they need to be modified, is there. Right? Some exercise, I can't modify it just because they're just weight, like 3-point row. Most people don't have a 3-point row problem, right? So how to regress it lighter weight. Sense. Okay. If their back can't be straight, then now you can use other tools like the bench, right? You can use stand up row, or just stand row, right? If that's what you're interested. Okay. So let's go through the exercises. Okay. Let's start with sprint. I want to point this out to make this very clear to you guys. Strength is the key to everybody's results here, right? For fat loss, for pretty much everything we do, strength is the number one key. Even if you're doing endurance training, Rachel is a started as an aerobic instructor and then she became a strength coach. And then even as a strength coach, she went and actually did an Ironman. She trained for a full Ironman, right? And even then she came back and she's like, I still need to do strength, right? But she did a lot of endurance running, swimming, all that good stuff. 13 hours of training a week. So 13 hours of training a week for a year. Per week for a year long. And she said that she lost a lot of muscle mass. She showed us pictures. Holy cow, what a difference between the two. You could actually go online and look up the problem. So strength training. So if somebody asks, hey, what day should I come? A lot of people here actually think that we have to do metabolic. They don't have to do metabolic, but they think they have to do cardio. That's not the case. At the conference, she showed tons and tons of evidence on that. She said all the evidence that she showed us in terms of scientific research and studies, cardio has zero effect on fat loss. Zero effect on fat loss. There was a study, check this out. 6 days, marathon runners ran a marathon a day for 6 days straight.
I mean, 26.2 miles
per day for 6 days straight. How many miles is that? 157.2 miles in 7 days, in less than 7 days, in a week.
There's people that do it.
Yeah. Right. So now we talked about how cardio is supposed to help you lose fat. That's extreme cardio, wouldn't you say so? Right? Extreme cardio.
Everything.
Huh?
Muscle.
Everything.
Guess how much weight they lost. Weight. We're not talking about that. How much weight? Wow. 6.1%. 6.1%.
Of their body weight.
Body weight.
But it's not muscle.
Guess how much of that is actually fat?
Not much.
So muscle water.
1%. Like less than 1%. 5.1 is all muscle. Right? Water you can gain back by drinking more, right? So these guys, if they're running 6 days straight, they're professional marathon runners. So they can recuperate on water pretty quickly. However, 5.1% of muscle is gone. To kind of show you how bad that is, it takes about a month to build 1 pound of muscle. So you burn 5% body fat, right? If you have 100 pounds of muscle, that's 5 pounds. That would take you about 5, 6 months to do. That you did, you just messed up in 1 week. Yeah. So make sure that people know that. Make sure that they don't think that if you do cardio too, don't suggest people do cardio. People think, hey, I don't have time to do this. I need to do cardio. Right? It's wrong. They need to live. They need to live. Yeah? Okay. So let's go into the exercise. Again, the ramp. I don't want you guys to call it warm-up anymore. Okay? Don't call it warm-up for two reasons. One, it is not a warm-up. Technically, it's not a warm-up. And two, people don't take you seriously when you call it a warm-up. Okay? If they don't take you seriously when you call it a warm-up, this is why people are late. Because they don't take it seriously. Right? What is it? What do we do before our workout?
So pre-workout.
What is it? Huh?
What
is it called? First of all. Range of motion.
Range of motion.
Activation. Movement preparation. That's what a ramp is. So when we do, hey guys, let's start ramping. Let's start doing a ramp. Like, make sure we use that word and not warm up. Because warm up, they can do it at home. They figure, hey, I can warm up anywhere they can be. I can warm up by myself, right? It's not a warm up, it is a ramp. Range of motion, activation, muscle movement preparation. If that's the case, then you as coaches, you have to make sure you take this seriously. This is the time when you start working on people. Yeah? Okay? so let's go through jogging.
Marching.
Let me grab some.
Change it to jogging?
No, I changed it.
Oh.
Okay. When you're looking at marching, opposite arm, opposite knee, it should look like skipping or running. Okay. They are activating, right? Their hip flexion, their glutes, their back, their chest, and their core. Okay. Good. Good morning. Good morning. Make sure when people are doing this that they're soft knee and not their knee locking out. So first thing that you do is make sure the back is straight, the knees are soft knees. And when they come up all the way, they squeeze their glutes. Right? A lot of the time they come up halfway, they come up here. This is not cool. So make sure we do that. Okay. And then as soon as we go to that, we go to skipping. Skipping is now progression of marching. Yeah? Okay.
A little bit faster.
Sorry, Alan just kicked my butt lately. Okay, next one is 2-point hip stretch. Ship stretch. 2-point stretch. Okay, so 2 points. One, two. We normally do 3 points. Right? We normally do 3 points. However, we don't have enough mats for people to do 3 points. Here, since we're doing a warming ramping, that we're doing 3 points. These two steps have to be big enough, or else they will not feel the stretch. Okay? So what it is just take step back big enough, and then we're going to lean forward, okay, and torso straight, and you should feel that stretch right in here on the hip flexor. Make sense? As I'm studying these hips and knees thing, I realized that most people hips, we have hollow hips, including myself, right? Myself, I think Anthony, Andrew, all have hip problems. So, we're going to do that for 30 seconds, 20 to 30 seconds, and then we're going to switch on the other side. Okay? Stick up. We're going to do stick up. Normally that's the one we do in the thing, but we're going to do stick up 30 minutes. So make sure you come just grab a spot. Grab a spot. So just anywhere, grab a spot. If they can't have a spot, make sure they stand next to the pole. They can do it on the pole as well. So if your hands are back far enough, but the back is being pulled, held back, so that way the arms can go back. Make sense? So you can put people right up. Okay. Backward lunges. Okay, backward lunges again. So you're ready to warm up those hips by doing the 2-point hip stretch. Now we're going to backward lunges. Make sure, again, on those backward lunges that people torso is straight. Okay, and you don't take a big back bar. Okay, and then, okay. This is also a chance for you to watch who you need to pay attention to when they work out. If they can't do a backward lunges correctly, later if we do offset lunges as a workout, you know who you need to keep an eye on. Does that make sense? Okay. So later when you see them do it, you can go over there and say, hey, make sure we do this, then you start correctly. Okay? You can want to start pull, but yeah. Caterpillar, all the way down, all the way up. No push-up. I don't care about that push-up. Okay? I want them to walk their hands all the way as far as possible. The core is getting activated because now we're into a plank position. Shoulder mobility, range of motion on the shoulder, the wrist, and the ankle, right? And the hamstring. Standing T's. Palm facing up on the standing T's, right? Arms going through the motion, and we're looking for that shoulder blade to be squeezed back. Yeah? When you guys are ramping, make sure that you show the exercises. But yet walk around. So I should not see you standing in the middle of the room just looking at everyone. Right? You might want to demonstrate close to the room. You could be over here. They could watch, and then you could do random and walk around, right? Or movement. Okay? Lateral lunges. Lateral lunges, okay? again, long distance split squats are different. A lot of long distance, your feet actually comes out and then come back. Okay. How far do you come out?
Wide enough so that they can stick their feet back in the knee.
Wide enough so that way the knee stays over ankle. Okay. Okay. So you. Okay. Look at me. Tell me if it's which one is. If I do this, notice when I lunge, where's my knee?
The knee's
outside. Yeah. Now, then there's people that exaggerate that, right? And they actually take a step out. Now, where's my knee? Wait, inside. Inside. Yeah? So, when I do this, now you notice how this knee is right on top of that knee. So that has to be wide. Spider-Man with rotation. Spider-Man with rotation. This one is a little tricky. So here, palms down. So I don't want to be here. The difference between here and here is very small, but it's a huge difference in terms of the extra stretch. Okay. Rotation, when you rotate, you always want to rotate with this hand. The inside hand, the one next to the right leg. The reason why is if I rotate with this hand, this hip, if I rotate with this hand, I can lock up my hips. Now I'm actually rotating my thoracic spine, because hips are locked in. Which one am I actually rotating?
Yeah, I have to walk, but when you do that, I have to walk around everybody.
Right, so what are the cues, right? Right hand forward, tell them the hand.
Yeah.
Right leg forward, right next to your hand, rotate with your right arm, right? And then left leg. You're gonna do 10 on the side.
Yeah.
Okay. Suitcase deadlift. Suitcase deadlift. We saw the suitcase deadlift last time on video, right? This time we're gonna do the same thing. It's nothing new that we're doing here. Nothing new. Make sure that when you see somebody picking up a weight, like if they're grabbing a weight weird, teach them. Tell them, hey, I'm teaching you technical way to lift a weight. I'm expecting you to use that on all the time, right? Don't, if you see somebody come over and just like stop, right? Be a good coach, right? They need to learn that that's a bad way of doing it. Make sense? Okay. Regression. Stick with the stick, the dowel, deadlift with the dowel, or stick, good morning, whatever you want to call it. Remember we did that last time? Not last time, we saw in the video, right? You put a stick on the back, have them hold it here, in here, right? One facing in, palm facing out. The important thing is that thing touch three parts of their back. One is their head, two parts of their back, one is their head. The other one is their thoracic spine, and the last one is their sacrum. All the time. Okay. So if somebody's doing deadlift and they're not doing it correctly, I need you to do that. Right? I need you to do that. Okay. I love the fact that Anthony does this, is that he uses a T-Rex. He comes over and I see people doing hip hinges with a T-Rex. Right? I love that. Here's the problem with that though, is that they don't have the feedback from the stick. Right. I would say that if I had to put progression on it, I would put the stick first as a regression, that's the lowest, and then I would go into the hip hinge with the TRX. Yeah.
Yeah.
Here, and then we'll just have him talk that high, actually, and then he'll just come out to this.
Holding on to the TRX.
Yeah, holding on to the TRX, and pushing down on the TRX. The cool thing about that is that as soon as you push down on the TRX, guess what happens? Your core is active. Core is active. So the problem with hip is that we don't have, including myself, we don't use enough core activated to stabilize. So with the hip hinge, we actually activate it by pushing down on it. As soon as you push down on those extremities, core is active. It's actually pretty cool. Okay, single arm push press again. On the push press, where do we break first? Knees or hips?
Where do you
bend? Where do we break first? Where do we bend first?
Hip.
Hip, break down, break back first, right? Okay. So keep that in mind. Okay, if they can't do that, then they should do a stick up on the wall. Right? So if somebody,
Well, sorry, the cue I gave them is like stick that stick your booty back.
You can, whatever cue you want to try to stick your booty back, put it back, right? Not a squat.
Yeah.
Not a squat.
Yeah.
Right? You've been doing a squat, not a squat. Right? So don't tell them squat. Don't even say squat. Tell them, hey, stick your butt back first. Can't do a stick up, it's great. Glute bridges, shoulder elevated, okay? Just feet on the benches. If you have people doing heavier weight.
Wait, hold on. You have your progression offset single arm push press?
Offset, sorry, thank you. Push press, you can do offset, single arm, so same thing, single leg, single arm, right? Okay, so they can do this, really core tight, back, and then press, okay? Learn something from watching that video. I've been telling you the offset wrong, definition of offset wrong the whole time. Wrong in the little thing, right? That makes it wrong. I always tell you offset is always the leg that is back, right? That is only half of the definition. Offset is always the leg that is moving, right? So lunges, right? Here, if I'm doing this, this is still the offset if I'm doing this, right? The leg that is moving, or the leg that leaves the floor. Does it make sense? Okay. So when I said offset plus lunges, which one is it? Is it if I'm doing front lunges, is it left side? Or is it all the way on the right side?
Front lunges?
Yeah.
Right side.
Right side. Because this leg is going to lifting off the ground. Okay. I always have this ability. So as soon as I lift off, this is offset. Does it make sense? Okay. So if I'm doing offset, this is offset. This is always as on the ground.
So then your leg would be on the
No, this side. Right side.
The weight's going to stay on the leg that's moving.
Exactly. Okay. Why? Because when you're moving, there's instability in moving, right? There's things that are changing. So when you load up that side, core has to work a little harder. putting this one in, and since this is new, we're actually putting in at 7 just in case, right? For tall people as well. because I don't want people to pick it in and out, so thank you. On this one, the wider the length of it, it's going to depend on how tall and short they are. Makes sense? Okay, if they're having trouble because it's so wide, like myself here, this is kind of awkward. It starts off straight, but it doesn't have to be straight the whole time. Okay, so when you come down, I can actually bend my arm as long as I come in. Makes sense? I don't have to keep that arm straight. You don't have to. Okay. The other thing that I saw, who was doing? I think it was YouTube. If you have to regress it, instead of pulling here, bring this in here, it makes it a little easier.
That's okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Again, on your feet, even when you stand, notice how my feet naturally comes into a wide stance or hip stance. Mm-hmm. It has to be narrow. So how do you do that? Is that that foot has to be in the middle of your body. Okay? And the other foot lines up. Okay? Make sense? Okay. Of course, if they can't do this, then you can wire it up a little bit, but that's about it, yeah? Okay, so same thing on the ground, is that again, if they want to wire it up because they can't fall, then that's fine, right? But your goal is to get them to line up, because you have to get those activated points. Make sense?
Wait, when you're demonstrating earlier, you have this in the
back. Yeah.
So then, on the other side,
so like
the one that's closer,
whatever's closest. lay closest to the anchor point. Right? Later we're going to do a lift, right? Lift is the same thing except that it's from, instead of from high down, it's going to be from bottom up. We'll do that another time.
Oh, from
the,
like kneeling?
Kneeling lift, because this is a kneeling chop. Okay, notice it's a little easier?
Yeah.
Instead of a balance, right?
Obviously, you have that white
together,
white
it's a little easier, right? For yeah. Type, this is
well, that opposite one just dips
everything. Yeah. Okay. So this is kneeling tall, and maybe one this day I'll not once, maybe, but soon I'll show you how to do a kneeling plank.
Are you supposed to pull both arms?
Yeah.
Together? Oh.
So notice how her arm ends right here, and that's fine. Right? It doesn't have to be straight.
And our stance, that's like, dude, like my hip. Just doing this, my hips are already activated.
Yeah, definitely. Right? It's more your core. Stay there. Both of you guys come over here and watch this. Stay there. No, relax. Just relax. Give me the six. No, it's fine. Stay there. Okay, so this is for you guys to see, so you guys can train your eyes. I'm actually getting better at this. Okay, her hips is actually so off.
Yeah,
you guys
she's
see that?
Sitting. Her right hip sits
yeah,
high.
Right. Okay.
And it's more exaggerated when she's in that.
Right. Now switch side. How about this side? Not as bad. Still bad, but not as bad. Yeah. The other side is a little bit worse.
Yeah. I feel it though.
Right. So one side you could actually, so a really good trick to look at this is imagine her wearing a belt. So go into double knee to me. Okay, so knee. Okay, if you she has to wear a belt. Belt buckle, right? Okay. So a belt buckle right here. Now bring one knee forward. Okay. Notice how now it's tilting. Right? So if somebody's doing this and taking a look at them, you know right off the bat that they have a hip problem. Right? Okay. Let's see. We're going to get off the subject a little bit today, but okay. A little. Okay. Squeeze your glutes. Okay. Better. A little bit.
Yeah.
Okay. So squeeze your glutes. Now abs tight, and then pull. Try to pull this down.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah, that's correct.
Okay. So a couple things. One is that she might be not
just
abs are not activated. As soon as we activate the abs and pull that, lengthen it down, now we're eating on the hips. This is why most of us have a big problem because the abs are.
Oh, yeah, see, look at that. When you let go,
right.
You're.
Right? But similar to mine, I actually. Very similar one. If I relax. Okay? Not as bad as hers. But yeah, it's still there. It might be as worse as worse. Okay, if I bring it in. This is why recently I'm having knee problems because of this offset.
Okay.
I don't see this much. It's probably more noticeable because she's got. For sure. No, she's got. Yeah. I've been I haven't played football in the last couple weeks, and so my hips are wrong. One is the mobility problem. One is the stability problem. Okay. Can you touch your toes? Yes. Mobility, you could actually have. That's weakened most of the time. I'm taking that out of your foot. Yeah. And for me, it's actually old. I can't touch my toes. Yeah, I mean, all anybody can touch their toes, right? But like if you're doing a straight leg toe touch, right? Come down, like I have to bend back and touch
yeah.
If I back my stretch. So I know I have a mobility issue. Right? Mobility is easier to fix because visually I can fix that. Right? Stability is the hard part. Might be wrong on this. So you know it, let them know it. So they know what you're fixing and what their problem is. Right? Two, it makes you become a more of an authority figure. You told them that nobody else ever trained them does it. Most people, I guarantee you most people. You, that out there training will not notice that. In fact, I've been telling Kevin about her hips for a while. Now that Offset lunges. Offset lunges, again, offset lunges, whatever weight you do. Here's the rule. You have to tell them in order offset lunges to work on their core, that weight has to be twice as much as their combined weight. Not twice as much, but it has to be combined weight with both hands. So if I do lunges with 15, right? My offset should be 30 pounds. My legs can handle 30 pounds, right? There's no reason for you to be less than 30. In order to challenge the core, again, it has to be at a weight that is significant enough. In order for it to be significant enough, your legs have to be able to handle it, which is the weight that they normally do. Make sense? And they do it and their body collapses, then you know that, hey, you have a core problem and go lighter, but you always start with the weight that is double or combined weight of both arms. Make sense? Roll out, you know how to do a roll out, right? Very simple. Guys, when you do a roll out though, make sure they know that they don't bring their hands close to their knees. They don't come all the way back in. As soon as they come all the way back in, there's something happens to their back. That rounds up. They just come into a quadruped position. That means, you know, shoulder on top of hand, and that's about it. And if butt comes in, butt comes out. Yeah? If they cannot do it right, if they cannot do it right, and they can do a plank, that just means that we need to get better at our coaching. Yeah? Does it make sense?
Yeah.
If they can't do it right, and they can't hold a plank, then they're just not strong enough. Yeah? And they roll out. Okay, I'll roll out for 3 seconds. Okay. And then our energy system training, burpees and push-ups. Okay. What they can do is they can do one of each and they kind of count up. So we're gonna do 1, 2, 3, all in 10. Okay. And they get to 10, they before 3 minutes, have them go backwards. Yeah? But I doubt that's gonna happen. Yeah, you're wrong for this. Okay.
Reps.
12 and 8. Right. Rep range, I want to do 8 and 15 and 8. 15 and 8. That means that the second time when we switch, they should increase some amount of weight, right? A good amount of weight for you. 5 pounds, 10 pounds. So that means if they're doing 15 for the first 2 weeks, the last 2 weeks should be 20 to 25. Yeah? 20 to 25. Not only are they getting stronger, they're getting better at the movement, so we need to make sure we do that. That means up it. Yeah? Okay. Push-up. Make sure we look work on their push-up. Question about strong head.
For the
push-up, you're
missing
all
kinds. Okay. So, on the knees, but around the back?
No.
So what's the okay one for
the, I don't care about what version you want to do this, but there's a couple things that you want to make sure that happens, right? It all correlates to mechanical or the anatomy of the body. One is the back is straight. You shouldn't arch the back either way. You, like a Hindu push-up or a cobra push-up, whatever you want to call it. Right off, so that can't be done, right? So that's number one. Two is it has, your hands has to line up with your elbows and shoulders. That's three. That's two. That's like the only two things that I have to look at. Okay, so let's go through different variations, right? You have a down, a docked push-up, whatever you want to call it, right?
That's fine, it's
right. No, that's fine, right? My back is still straight, right? Yeah, that's fine. The core is not as aggravated. Okay, so somebody might do that because they're not strong in their core.
You should be regressing to kneeling if that's, or?
Like I said, that's up to you guys, right? The only two things that I look at is one, are they doing push-up like this?
Okay.
If their elbows are out and not good to their shoulders,
yeah.
I don't want that, right? Sure, you could regress it down to to the knee, right? And then the hands, hand position. I don't care where your hands are, right? As long as the elbows match. Okay, so I'm here. Make sense? Rather than. Okay. Want to make this straight. The fastest way to get somebody stronger is not for them to do the same exercise. Does it make sense? I'll kind of give you an example. Okay. A lot of times people say, well, just got to practice it. So let's do, I can't do push-ups, right? I can't do push-ups. So instead of regressing it, let's just do push-ups on our feet. Does it make sense? And we'll practice it and we'll get stronger. Right? We sure can. Nothing wrong with that, right? You wouldn't use the same analogy if somebody said, hey, I want to squat 250 pounds, and they can't squat 250 pounds, right? You don't put them on and just continue doing it, eventually you'll get stronger. What do? You regress it to a lighter weight, and they go to 250 pounds a lot faster than you just throw them. Same thing with the push-up. The idea that we regress, so that way they progress faster. Does it make sense? Right. It shouldn't be, hey, just let them practice it, they'll get it eventually. No, you have to regress the exercise. One, you take away the risk of injury, and two, they progress a lot faster that way. It has to be done that way. Make sense? Okay. That is the reason why a good CrossFit has a good progression system. You guys are all CrossFitters, right? Good CrossFit has a good progression system. Others don't, they just tell you to continue doing it. Like, no, there has to be a progression. They can learn it faster. Make sense? Okay. And then, offset lunge, roll out, okay, push up. Okay, any other questions? Okay, 15 breaths. 15 to 20 breaths. Okay, I don't care so much about the time, so deep breathing. For plank, they can't do a whole lot.
Oh.
And they're doing a plank. I don't care. Don't count 30 seconds. I tell people to count 30 seconds. But now I'm switching on to breathing.
Uh-huh.
Inhale, exhale. That's one breath.
Deep
breath. Right? You activate more that way. Okay. Just go to B.
Yeah. So on the certified, I have this lady and she's top heavy. So what she was doing was like really wide, and then she was doing this.
Okay.
And then I told her, you know, can you do a plank for me? She couldn't do it.
Right.
And then, so then she said, she told me, she said, well, the other trainer told me to just get my stance that wide.
Right.
Yeah, so that's okay.
It is okay technically because she's not going to hurt herself,
right?
But now you have to look at it, which one would progress her to doing stir the pot the correct way the fastest?
To get to develop her plank.
Yeah. Very good. So always ask yourself that. Always ask yourself that. Okay. Two, makes a good point. We are not perfect. You guys are going to be training people, and sometimes I'm going to come in and train people. So if somebody said, hey, there's other folks who are going to do this way, tell them, okay, that's fine. Continue doing it unless you found out that, unless that, whatever they're doing is going to hurt them. Okay. If that's the case, I guarantee you that they didn't say it. They said it's something else, and that person just did it wrong, right? So if it's wrong and it needs to be improved before they get hurt, go in there and let them know, okay, that's fine. I'm just going to make a small adjustment so you don't hurt yourself. Okay? And then do that, right? But if it's that, bring it up in the meeting so we can get that clear which one is better, right? You could be right on this, right? But again, the other coach could be right on this, right? So we want to talk about that. Okay. Yeah, B. Let's go through the exercises first. Deadlift, right? Deadlift. A regression for deadlift is the dowel hip hinge, right? We talked about that last time, earlier. Make sure you get a dowel and, you know, 3-point contact, head, thoracic spine, and the sacrum, that's the head to the point. Then we tell them to sit back on the butt, their back, the butt sits back, right? I don't care about that knee bending or that, right? With all the injuries and all the athlete lately, when they, you know, they're messing with their legs, like extending and overextending that knee, some experts actually blaming straight leg deadlifts. Right? The knees aren't converting to bend when it needs it. So, straight leg deadlift actually was, I told you this before, it was invented. Romanian deadlift actually was invented because the Romanians used that to practice their Olympic lifting. But to this point, it's the Romanian deadlift. Train up to get over the knee. So, because we don't do Olympic lifting, we might not have to do that so much.
So, Americans, they bend their knees?
Romanian deadlift or straight-legged deadlift? Straight-legged deadlift is the technical name for it. The Romanian is because we saw the Romanian did it back in the 1986 Olympic lifting tournament. And nobody else was doing it except for the Romanian. So the nickname was Romanian deadlift. Grip trainer, standing facing close grip row. Okay.
Standing facing the ankle.
Yep, standing facing the ankle point. Okay. Close grip. So I want it to be 1-3 or 1-2? 1-4, 1-2. Okay. Okay. So the stance, the number is 1 at the farthest way from the anchor point, right? This is 1, this is 2, this is 3, 4, and 5. Okay, so on this close, it's either 1 and 4, 1 and 3, 1 and 2. Okay, more, when you go that way, you get more and more. Okay, split stance. Offset from that. What are legs next? They can't do it wider.
So your progression is single leg?
Single leg.
So you're looking at one leg?
One.
That's closer to the wall?
No, you're facing, there's no wall. Whatever side of the core is on. So the resistance on the left side, my left leg is up. So row, right? But here, pull the band will pull this way, right?
On the shoulder,
and two, listen, they can't you jump, right? Unless you're super tall, falling down there is kind of. If we don't remove the risk of injury, we move it at all costs. We move it at all costs. Right? There's no, unless you're tall, like, yeah, Andrew, Anthony, right? They can do the lower body and they still be fine. Right? You and I, that's a long fall. That's a whole story right there. Yeah. I said you and I, so you're okay. Okay. Pull up. Side note, how do you help somebody do a pull up? Progress, and so they're doing this really well. How do we make that person do pull up faster or increase that?
I usually just have them slow down. And you like make sure you count three.
It's really interesting. So for the last, not last, but the beginning of my my first 5 years, that was the question that I get asked the most. I want to do a pull up how? So I'm designing programs, I'm designing to do, you know, pulling motion, vertical pull, horizontal pull, to stabilize it. In the last conference I went to, they made it very simple. Right? You have to do two things. You just have to increase the time under tension. Okay? What does that time under tension mean? Hanging time. You can't carry it, you can't lift it. In this version, you can hang, you can't do a pull-up.
So hang on the bar.
Hang on the bar. Okay, three versions. Two or the rings, right? So two ways though. You hang here, and then you hang here or here depending on what version you go.
But okay? You're awake.
Yeah, you're hanging, right? You're just hanging. Right? So you hear you hold it for longer. If you can hold here for 40 seconds, you can hear you hold it for 40 seconds, your brain will connect here to here. Does it make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So normal people, Andrew asked me this a couple months ago, he said, I need to increase my pull-up. He's training for military, and he could do, what is it, 100 pull-up push-ups and sit-ups?
He has to do it.
No,
you get tested on it?
Is that test on pull-ups, run, and sit-ups?
But what are you doing? 10 minutes, 110 or 300 or something?
Oh, 100 pull-ups, 100 sit-ups, 100 push-ups in 10 minutes.
In 10 minutes. So he said he couldn't, he wanted to increase that, that pull-up. So I told him if you can hang here, hang here, and the pull-up will take care of itself.
So why
is it? It doesn't matter what it is, whatever you're practicing for. The idea is if you can't carry it, so let's say my grip, I can only hang here for 10 seconds. No matter what happened, I can only do pull up for 10 seconds. That could be one rep, that could be 10 reps. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
If I can hang here for, I can increase from 10 seconds to 20 seconds, suddenly now I can hang a little longer and do a little more push up, more pull up. Does it make sense? If I can only hang here for 10 seconds, every time I come up there, it's one, right? That means I can only do 10 seconds. Worth of that. That means only 10 pull-ups. If I can hang there for 20 here and 20 here, my body can do it. Make sense? Mm-hmm. Trade code comes up.
I've learned on scapular stretch on that too.
Oops.
On what?
So this is pretty scapular.
Scapular pull? Yeah, right. Yeah, this is really interesting. Like I said, when I developed like first 5 years of my career when I was doing it, because everybody was asking, so I made all these programs, right? And then, so when I started training you guys, I really got into the full scapular pull. I always talk about scapular pull horizontally, vertically, and then he comes to me and says, you know what, do it, and your body, you know, it will do it, right?
No, I did that one time.
Shot it in the suit?
First.
Oh, okay.
I saw it in the 5 years.
Yeah.
So I'm going to do that.
Yeah, the scapular?
The scapular, the hanging.
Yeah. Lateral pull down, stability ball, chest press, and stability ball, chest press. Legs, make sure the legs are a little wider than your hips, okay? My progression on that one was on that one, close hand. Here's the reason why I didn't put it there. It is dangerous. Stability ball, chest press, okay? So most of the time you have your feet wide apart, right? And one progression, why I took it out when you don't have progression there, is that doing this gives you that more progression. However, there is that, if risk injuries if this collapse, your core collapses, right? We can do better than that. So we want to increase the weight minimum to really focus on that core, right? So instead of adding the extra risk, I decided to take that out, right? So they can't do it, they can always go ahead. Regression, they can't do one arm because they can't do it right. Again, this is not doing their chest press correctly, right? Elbow under the wrist, they can't do single arm, that's double arm. Cannonball, single leg supplying hip extension with the tennis ball. Okay, I'm gonna get some tennis ball, but many times I can't get tennis ball, like that. I'm gonna never do
this.
This
is not really
okay. Come down. Okay. Both feet on the ground, just lay there. Okay, palms up. Okay. Raise your hips up beside you. Pretty good extension, yeah? Would you say? Okay, knee to shoulders, straight line. Okay. Actually, do this angle to that one. Raise your right leg up, and then bend your knees. Okay. So pull this as tight as you want as possible. Okay, now do the same thing. Okay, come back down. Okay. If you guys can you see, make sure your foot lines up correctly, right? Okay. Come out like that, because your hips. Okay, now let's line up correctly. I'm in here. There we go. Now do the same thing. Okay, good. Now do the other side. So one, the reason why we're holding this, and I want to show you all the progression on this, is that we're going to actually try to get her abs to squeeze this, okay? So I'm going to have it close, and I'm going to have you squeeze that ball, okay? Now do the same thing, okay? Okay, back down. Yes, sir. A little bit. Okay. Okay. Good. Okay, how's that?
Yeah.
Okay, feel the difference?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Because you have that ball, too,
mm-hmm.
for your feet.
Right. So the ball, what it does is you want to do it so the ball doesn't fall out. One is it activates the core, so when she's doing this, it's just like the other stuff. She's activating that core, keeping that core, okay? Making sure that her knee and her feet lines up correctly.
Oh, that is not
your
feet.
Yes.
It's not moving.
Yeah, right? Make sense? Okay.
So you want that just right on
mm-hmm.
the hip crease?
Right. To go back down again? Do the same thing. This time let's go higher. So what else?
Now my foot is going up on there.
Yeah, and that's fine, but look at the range of motion on her hip. You see how it doesn't go all as high as it before? Right? And this is because now she's activating, because now it's not as easy as down here. Now you're up in, you know, here.
Yeah?
Okay. So a little bit more let's do the other side. No higher. You see that? Okay, a little harder?
Yeah.
Okay, so this is actually a corrective exercise. It's not a workout, guys. It's not an exercise. It's a correct way to stick up, right? So when you're doing this, you gotta teach people that this is not an exercise. They're gonna come here, they're gonna come on the ball, they're trying to do everything as possible. And we're pull up here. This is what we're working on, right?
Yeah.
So we wanna make sure that we educate them. Yeah? Okay. I'm gonna have it. Can you create it? Yeah, the same thing. Okay. So guys, if you know this is your problem, and you know that an exercise on a day that you work out, there's a lot of good coaches, deadlift and whatnot, right? Use this as a ramp for yourself. Yeah? Use this as a ramp. Same thing with the chop, right? So we're gonna just do one thing. Okay, back down. Okay, single leg. Back down. Okay. And I'm gonna have you go up as high as you can, yeah? There you go, good. Come back down. Do the other side. Okay. Come back down. Okay. Yeah, there you go, good.
What's that?
Your toes are pointing out.
Oh, right. Is it supposed to be?
So this.
You go like this.
Oh, I mean, trying to lift on the other side. So was it on the other side?
No, what happened is that your toes point out like this.
Oh.
Yeah. Okay, so when you do that, there you go. Good. Good catch. Good catch. Here's the reason why the toes turns out is because the hips are compensating. Do the same thing. Go for it. Okay. Slightly not as high. Yeah.
Because you're trying to hold on to that ball.
It's correlated. I mean, it's your abs just activates because you're holding the ball. You're shutting this down, right? You're actually shutting this down. So that hip is actually doing all the work at this moment. Okay. And so right now you can't compensate. You can't use this side to help with that side. I mean, hips can't compensate. So, okay, and then let's go higher.
Okay.
Damn, awesome. Okay, so when you look at the video before, right, the guy that was working on that video would deadlift 500 pounds and squat 5'4" or something, right? So, like, at that guy, he's compensating a lot for that, but he's doing it, right? You guys are athletes yourself. You guys can do it. Doesn't mean that we're doing it correctly. We're compensating for something, right? So one is that very similar. I think this is why you pull your abs when you're doing deadlift, because we're compensating so much for those hips that eventually something is going to snap, right? So the idea is that, hey, we are getting stronger, but what are we giving up? As long as we're not giving up anything to compensate to give that gain, we won't get hurt. Does it make sense? Right. So same thing when people lift weight, just because they're not lifting 500-600 pounds like we do, right, doesn't mean that they're not gonna get hurt. Make sense? Okay. So as you guys are working out, make sure that we find out what you can't do and add that to your rep. Yeah, spend some time with your rep. Okay. So when they get up, like, wow, this is so much harder than
I can't have every part of my body.
Right. Okay. Loud lunges and mountain climbers. Loud lunges and mountain climbers. Yep. Four rounds. Okay. Keep this in mind. If somebody can't do that, right? Somebody can't do that at all, and they can't do regular glute bridges because their hips couldn't go all the way up, guess what we do? Guess what we rest to? Just regular hip bridge. Your feet on the ground and bring your butt up as high as you can. And then if you're struggling really bad and the ball's in there, okay, every location has about 6 or 7 or 10 of these balls, right? Grab them, come here, bring it over here, bring the whole basket if you want to, yeah? And just do that. I'm going to bring some tennis balls. Lateral lunges. We know how to do lateral lunges, okay? So lateral lunges to mountain climbers. 20 seconds on, 20 seconds off. That's one exercise, four rounds, both exercises. So you're going to do each exercise four times. Each exercise four times. Jogging, knee up, toe touch to squat. We don't have a toe touch to squat. Okay, we're doing toe touch to squat a little different, guys. Squat. Okay. Feet shoulder apart. You're gonna come down, right? You're gonna come down. Back straight first. Okay, and then bend the knee into you. Grab your toes. Okay, and I'm gonna drop my butt down. Push my knees out. Okay, it's hot. Huh? Do we show us okay? I don't remember.
Yeah. We did.
Right, so squat knees out, right? So we want to, now there's a squat exercise. Goblet squat is the exercise that we're looking for, right? So we want to make sure we're ramping movement preparation, right? Range of motion, okay? So we're coming down here as a toe touch, right? Toe touch, grab your toes. And last time we did it, we were here and we're doing this. Grab your toes, elbows pushing your knees out, and you're going to come down, right, as far as you can, right, and then bring up, and we're going to squat up. Make sense? Okay. That's the toe touch to squat. Perfect. Big split stance, tricep stretch. And this is also a hip mobility. And big step, extra. We're going to tricep stretch the same hip that is back. Okay? Why are we doing that? Because your lats connect your shoulder to your hip. And we stretch that. This lat up, and get extra stretch from here. Okay? Again, it has to be big enough step. If I'm doing this here, nothing is being stretched. Yeah?
That last
one right now, that's 100 pitches. No, that's the big split points. You're on the same beat.
Oh.
We know how to do a piriform stretch. Big split stance and tricep stretch. W. Okay. When they do W's, a couple keep one thing is that one shoulder is their back straight. Two is that when their hands are doing this, they rotate their full whole forearm is rotating. So here, you're gonna rotate full forearm. That makes sense? Okay, so it's here. Like if you're gonna do standing W, it's here. Two, two. Right here. Put that in your shoulder blade when you did that. Mm-hmm. Your scapulas, right? So that should be the same thing. Do it again, same. Do it again. Standing, standing. So when you see her doing this, okay, notice how the forearm falls forward. Okay? Okay. I want you to do that. The difference?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So what happens when they're doing it? Their elbows come back. But if you come up here, you get more engaged.
So the line of here is your ears.
That's something you have to be more in. They have to actually do it. I've tried a lot of stuff, and I do that. They can't do it because their back is not parallel. Have them stand up, right? You can always regress the ramp as well, yeah? Don't think that the ramp is just not regressing. They always stand up. Staying wise, okay, lock out the elbows when you do this. Okay, this is the, a cool one to learn in the last couple weeks. And it's going to prep them for the deadlift. Okay? So what you're going to do is a deadlift with a shoulder rotation. Okay? What you're going to do is you're going to tell them to get a deadlift and relax the arms, right? The arms relax. What you're going to do is you're going to tell them to pinch your shoulder blades back and down. That's all we're looking for. Here, to here, and then down. Okay? Really good verbal key for it is here. And tell them to squeeze their arm next to the armpit. So down and close the armpit together. They want to close it off. Okay? This is what a deadlift should look like. It shouldn't be here. It should be here.
Okay.
Your arm, your tricep, back of your arm to your armpit. Close it off. That means when I come by, you can't touch your armpit. A lunge twist, again, when you're doing a lunge twist, you're twisting to the outside knee, the front of the outside. Drop that back knee, you're twisting. We're just... Hanging upright row means that. Oh, sorry, my nose is good. Push-up rotation. Do a push-up, rotate. Do a push-up, rotate. Hanging upright row is here, okay? Your hands above. like an Olympic lift. When you do it hanging, the bar is above the knee. When you're doing it with a kettlebell or a dumbbell, your hand has to be above the knees, yeah? Can't do it right, eliminate that, do upright or low, right? Okay, and they can do that really well. Teach them how to do it clean. Teach them how to do it clean. So that's progression. So we can't teach people to do progression if they can't get that weight up by themselves. Does it make sense? So we have to do it. Okay, here. Okay, up, shoulder to ears. Okay. You can do it either way. Of a learning that when you learn, you find out that you're adding so much stuff. Until you master it, is when you start eliminating stuff. Does that make sense? So that's to show you that I haven't mastered this thing.
I think
you
lost a lot. I think that's more challenging than you're putting weights on.
Yeah, right, because you're doing it right. Hanging upright row, step up, goblet squat. TRX twist, we know how to do that, right? Feet pointing both away and then up. That is it. Regression for that, do it more vertical. Yeah? And can't do that anymore, do it from the, do it with the resistance band. Twist. 3-point row, and then bike. Okay? Regular spike and then single leg for spike if you want to regress, progress, regress. That's right. Okay. I want to make sure that you guys stick to these regression and progression. Why? Because then next time somebody was working with them, they're not working on something different, right? The next time you're doing it and they're like, oh, single leg, yeah, Anthony was working with me last time. Okay, cool. This is, you know, then now we're working on like a team to help that person. Does it make sense? Okay. So I want to make sure we progress in the same way and regress in the same way. right? Unless the pre-question is just something that they can't do, you know, then you want to think out of the box and be sure. Okay. Overhead lunges, okay? We can do overhead lunges one side only. And then we're going to go into no rest in between. As soon as they switch, they kind of come down, and they're going to do a single leg plank push-up. Remember a plank push-up? You do a plank, and you get your hands, you come back to your elbows. Right? Single leg, okay? Somebody can't do a single leg, then they just do a regular plank push-up. Make sense? Okay. If somebody can't do a plank push-up, then they just do a plank. See how that progression is?
Is it weights or is it lunges?
Oh, yeah, just overhead. Lock out. Yep, just lock out, elbows, biceps, ears. Yeah? How do you progress in overhead lunges?
Jump in overhead lunges.
Yeah.
What's the time?
Right there. Sorry. 0 seconds. I did. Done! No, it's 20 seconds. 20 seconds of lunges and then
30 seconds of plank.
Wait, 20
seconds of lunges,
20
seconds of plank.
30 seconds. Oh, 30 seconds. 30 seconds of plank, and then
afterward,
you rest for
20
seconds. Yep.
30
seconds.
Yep. Oh.
Let's go into metabolic pain. Yeah? Jogging, scapula push-ups. I just want to let you know this, why I'm doing this, so that way you can see this. I'm getting people to get up and down. Right? Mm-hmm. When we first started, we wanted people to start standing up and working down. I'm going to switch back and forth. The reason why is that one of the stuff that we want people to get better at is get up. Get up is one of the primary movement. So how do I do that without doing it? I'm just going to switch from a standing one to a sitting one. They're going to get up and get down on their own. Does that make sense? Okay. So jogging, the scapula push-ups.
That's better than being flexible.
Yeah, but my primary reason again is that up and down to do that primary movement. Caterpillars, full body extension, push-ups, downward dog to a push-up plank. Cat, can you demonstrate that? Okay, so you start with this in the push-up position.
Cleanse down the back, so push-up position.
Yeah. And then you go into a downward dog. We'll come back. That's
all. Oh. Where did you get that? I had it in my back
today. Okay, when you're doing that, the one that was taught to me was they're doing that into a cobra. I don't want us to do a cobra because that's extension of the back, right? Over extension of the back. Lunges, piriformis stretch, Spider-Man stretch with rotation. We talked about that. Mountain timer, battle circles. Yeah. Okay. Do you want to do circles inside or outside? I don't care. Circles. Thrusters, they can't do thrusters, so I'm going to do squat. Okay, T-Rex lower back extension. Okay, straddle step squat. Yeah, that is station number one. Yeah, okay, take no rest. You're going to go 25 seconds on, 25 seconds off, 25 seconds on, 30 seconds off, 25 seconds on, 35 seconds off, 25 seconds on, 35 seconds off. 90 seconds rest in each loop round. Okay, so, and then we go into.
So we're gonna have two stations set up.
Yeah, two stations set up. So you can break them into, hey, this group did this station, this group did this station. Right? With this, you can fit 40 people. Right? Resistant, rip trainer back swing, half burpees, 2-point alternator in a row, or high knee. Yeah? again, we talked about this with Joyce. Joyce can't do an exercise. What you do is you eliminate it completely. Yeah? Eliminate it completely. I told her on the metabolic day as well as strength day. So we can't do it. You can't take it. You can't. She can't do a goblet squat. We rated deadlift. Hey, let's have you work on your corrective exercise. We know she needs it. Corrective exercise more than anything. And I'm talking to her to get her to work on her fat loss, so it helps her with working out, right? And we know that nutrition is the number one thing on that, right? Because Alyssa Lamb has not worked out this week, I believe. Am I correct? After her injury?
Yeah.
Right. She lost more weight this week than she did not, since it's how we study. Right.
She's
really
well, she's really watching this.
Right. Studies showing that nutrition alone gives you 8.2 or 8.8% fat loss. Working out gives you 2.2. Combined, you get 10.9 or 10.11. The only problem is that when you combine it, they get worse results. Okay, any question on metabolic pig?
So it's just 8 stages, right?
No, so there's 4 stations, so it's like, station 1 is over here with 4 exercises. They just rotate through the 4 exercises.
Okay.
Right.
So you're going to do 4 rounds each station.
Right, 4 rounds each station, and then you're going to rotate the station later. Yeah? So, metabolic beat, same thing. This time you're going to have 3 stations. Okay. Alternate weight, lunge press. Okay, when you do a lunge press, make sure they press on top, just like how a thruster would, right? Think of a lunge press as a single leg squat press.
So you lunge back.
Yeah,
backwards.
Then press on top. Wacky jack, angry wacky jack, do jumping jack. T-Rex, upper body extension, volley jump, and fast hand step. We have not done fast hand step in a while. Yep. Trainer, standing facing side, twisting to stand facing front with the press. Jump rope and mount plunge. Okay. This one here, the jump rope, if we can do it inside, do it inside. If we can't do it inside, do it outside. Yeah? And you can switch wacky jack and mountain climbers and switch them. Meaning that, hey, there's more shade in the front. Have that to be where jump rope would be. Make sense? If later at night the shades are more in the back, then have it here in station 30. Make sense? Another ball at sea. Jump rope. One, the ramp is longer. It's 10 minutes long. Okay, we actually test this out on Saturdays, but 45 seconds is too long, so we're doing 35 seconds now. So it's 35 seconds on, 35 seconds off. You have 90 minutes rest after each round. There's only 2 rounds. Let people know that there's only 2 rounds. Right? Don't come back and they're going, this is what's gonna happen. They're gonna come to round 2. That was it. Because they are naturally thinking that it's 4, they're gonna pace themselves the first, and the second one they're gonna be like that second, right? So let them know there's only 2 rounds, right? Okay. Jogging, toe touch to squat, perform a stretch, knee hugs, skipping, scapula push-ups, fireman stretch, full body extension. Again, full body extension. You want people to squat with their hands back on the bottom and then touch for the ceiling on the top. Hands on the side. Just no, full body extension is exactly what it looks like if you're doing a jumping squat.
Oh.
Okay, so jumping squat's here, here.
Okay.
Make sense?
Okay.
Yep, push that. Should be doing that without warming up. I didn't realize I was going to do it.
You got excited.
Three D lunges, 3D lunges, forward, backward, side. I don't care what order, so forward, side, backwards, one, right? So hit one of those and do it. Push-ups, side knee lift, knee circle, knee lift, knee circle. Yeah? When they do a knee side knee lift, make sure they don't straighten out the leg. When they do knee circle, same thing, they don't straighten out the leg. They have that 90 degree bend. In that position, that's really bad for this problem.
Well, even prior to that, a lot of those are the workers that we have. And I just tell them, make sure that your shoulders are
aligned. That's going to help a little bit, but it's not going to help much. If that's the case, they just got to take a break in between. Right? This is something that they have to get
to.
They're on their knees now.
Yeah. Kind of give you an example.
Can you do it like this?
You can, right? You can keep your knuckles straight. The other thing is that it's something that they have to get used to, right? Up to a certain point, is them getting used to it, and up to a certain point with their body from being off the support for so long. Can I give you an example? When Kat and I trained over the focus group, it's a company down the street from here. Everybody was complaining about the wrists. Right? More so than here. I'm not talking about like, hey, we don't have it, but they do it very fast, right? And the reason why is they have to condition their wrists. Okay, so a lot of stuff is just, guys, one, make sure that their feet point up dorsiflex, right? Two, now they're gonna lift one leg up as high as they can, okay? That's it, okay? Notice how this leg stays the same, okay? As long as she starts pivoting this out like this, okay, what is she doing is she's actually relaxing this hip. So this hip drags down, allows this to come up more. Okay, so you want to make sure this stays here, and that comes up, and all she does is that. Like, lift all the way down, and all the way up. Yeah, 30 seconds more than that. Okay, as far as you can, okay, that's active leg raise. So on the 25th, there's one side, and then, you know, the other side you do it, then be at the other side. Yeah? Okay, come back down. Okay, so active leg raise, okay? So on November 1st, you actually have leg raise or leg lowering, okay? Leg lowering is the more advanced version. Take a look at this, both legs up for me, all the way up. Okay, hold this press here, okay? What you're gonna do is this one leg stays here. Notice how she pronated, okay? Relax, okay? So pronation is actually also a hip thing. Do you know that? I learned that. It's actually really interesting. Okay, so here, and then what happens is the one leg, this leg, lower. Come back up. Okay, the lowering is the working part. The coming up is not. So coming down, I want to go to those more slow, and then come up, I don't care. Okay, so most people think the lifting part is actually the workout for this one. That's why
so
the leg is lower.
Slow.
Okay, I'm not lifting, I'm lowering. The other one, lifting, is the one we're looking at. Okay? So that's leg lift or leg lowering, depending on which one you want to do to set up somebody. So if you want to regress somebody, go to leg lifting. You want to progress and somebody does well like Kat, I probably want her to do leg lowering. Okay? Notice how Kat mobility is really good, and this is why her hip is not a mobility problem.
Hard on your scapulas. Yeah. Jeanette's the one who progressed to that.
Okay, the squat with the band around the knees, that's the one that we need to see which one we need to do. Okay. Let me show you. There's only two places that you can do that with. Is that one with the grip trainer? Right? Is that one with the grip trainer?
There's a pitch.
Easiest way, the reason why I team it up, if you gotta come over here, you might want to do this prior to, just gonna get one of these bands and you're gonna hook it. So that we lock it. Make sense? Okay.
And then
okay. What you do is you're gonna have to come in. I prefer this to do it over here because we can actually. Okay. And it doesn't have to be hard, guys. It could be a yellow band or a red band, okay? So what you're gonna do is just in front or behind. Okay, try to be low their knee, okay? And here we're just gonna squat, okay? What happened is this band is making help. Okay, and it's probably gonna collapse my knee like this, right? What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna actually push out, squat. That's all I'm doing. I'm pushing this out so it doesn't clap. Squat as slow as I can, and then come up. Facing the wall again, the idea is if it collapses your knees, you need to push it out.
Push.
Cool? Okay. I don't know. Is there anything else that's particular? If you want to push it out, get the core, quad, push, press, head lift, lift out. All the presses for the exercise. Okay. If somebody could do the deadlift position correctly, see what they do. Next day they test them, then change.
You mean a pull down immediately after?
Yeah.
You can stretch later in the day.
Right. But their test, right? Their test, their study, they kept them the same nails after the 24 hours or the next day. They did vertical jump and horizontal jump and all this other stuff. Testing wise, very little difference in terms of performance. Warm up, however, changed. Warm up, they actually see a difference in performance the next day. So that's why I keep telling you guys, CAC, that cool down, it's not so much about them actually cooling down. One, we're teaching them what to do if they decide to do that at home. And the most important thing. Two, is that we get everybody closer together as the family, right? Introducing new people, right? And Josh, if you know somebody's birthday, congratulate them. If you know somebody hit a milestone, congratulate them, right? Rather than actually cooling down. Makes sense, announcement, stuff like that. Yeah. So that cool down 3 to 5 minutes, if we have more time, 5 minutes, sit down, talk to them, get to know them. Anthony does a really good job with that, Jeff does a really good job with that. Once you start focusing too much onto it, it doesn't help them any much more than diet. Okay? So that's it. Any questions for me? One last thing, and then we're done. Make sure that
we're going to teach
Penny. First one there.
Okay. This is a Saturday workout. Anthony can do this, but I want you to set up for you. Just in case you have any. Okay, let's. So there should be five Saturdays. There should be five of them. Okay.
Three
C's, correct. Make sure all three C's are different, yeah? The warm-up are very similar, because all the workouts and the stuff are very similar, so the work the ramps are very similar, it's not identical. Okay? So let's date them. Metabolic A, is this Saturday. Anybody have a calendar up?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah, it's the fourth.
Yeah, Saturday. So metabolic the workout A, metabolic A on that is the fourth. Mm-hmm. B is the 11th. C is the 18th. Yeah.
There's one that starts with
the battle of the whole way. The one with ASLR. ASLR is your first period of 18.
Okay.
Yeah, ASLR is 18.
Okay.
And the one with the battle of the way first will be the 25th. And the last one will be November 1st.
There's a double
wave
and
then
a
giant wave. Oh, which one do you
have? Is that
the
double wave. Double
wave is 20. The small wave is that big one. Progression there's two part of this. Okay, so get the steps out when you need to. What you do is they're going to come down, put their toes on that, right? And they're going to touch their toes. Okay? As soon as they finish that, you're going to do whatever rep that is. They're going to go now on the back and make sure their heels on there. And they're going to do the same thing. Okay? So toe touch progression, you're actually doing it. And they're going to reach, they're going to bend down first, guys. They're going to bend down first like a deadlift. As soon as they can't bend anymore down, then they squat. And so then they're bending from their knees. So hip bends first, and it's as far as they can, and then knees comes in. Does that make sense? That's toe touch progression. From your feet, and then from your heel, and from your toes. Okay, and then metabolic on the bottom. Metabolic, there's five exercises. There's burpees and jumping jacks in parentheses, just in case there's more than 20 people.
There's always more than 20 people.
Only on one of the sessions. Usually it's never like 25, right? It's always 25, 15.
Saturday was 22,
27. Okay. If that's the case, add both of them, right? You have both of them, you have six exercises, I believe. Six exercises times up by 5 and 30. They're going to do the roll for 20 seconds, take a rest for 25 seconds, and we're going to do burpees for 20 seconds. Then we're going to rest in 25 seconds, and then we're going to rotate. Does that make sense? Okay. And then we're going to do the other exercise for 20 seconds, we're going to rest for 25 seconds, and then we're going to do burpees again for 20 seconds. Right? So very burpees, dominated exercise. Question on that? Yep, just one rep. I don't know. Hey, you only have one rep. It shouldn't have any rep training. Question on that? No? Okay, next one. Really what I'm interested in, the next one is actually. I want to do this, it is semi-strength, semi-metabolic, kind of want to look at it, but every exercise has a corrective exercise with it. Okay? I don't care how you change it, the way you want to do this over here in La Habra, as long as corrective exercise follows the workouts. Make sense? So one stays together, two stays together, and does it make sense? Okay. So it's 30 seconds on, that 15 seconds allowed to get to the next exercise, or the movement, or getting into that movement.